Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. I hope that you will stay tuned to this video as I share some thoughts with you. So here I'm looking at my koi and goldfish pond, and you guessed it by now, I am presently managing the plants that are in the pond. Now, as with even your aquarium inside your house, you at times will need to actually trim the plants. Now the plants have dead leaves on it at times, and sometimes it have, especially water lilies, right? Even the other plants in which you have in your tanks will have dead leaves on it. It will have extended roots. It will have at times some insects in which probably you do not want, and sometimes it may even prevent you from actually observing your tank or pond properly. Now I take it in stages, in which I change my water every 2 weeks, I do siphoning every 4 weeks, and I trim my plants every 4 weeks. I can't do everything one time, so I am taking it step by step. Now I have actually trimmed all the plants, taken off the dead leaves, and this should, and by the way, this just come out of this set. So for the entire month, this is what was produced. So I'm now replacing back the plants that have been properly, you know, clipped and managed, so as to encourage new growth within the plant and to allow the water to remain fresh and the pH to be really good. What you should understand, however, is that the plants, plants play a significant role in the management of your pond. They help to keep down the nitrites and the nitrates in your pond. Some of us neglect to realize that the rotten leaves actually put the rotten leaves and roots actually put, or should I say, encourage the existence of nitrates and nitrites in your tank again. So it's a cycle. So what you should ensure is that all avenues are covered, and at no point in time the risk of poisoning your fish through excessive nitrites and nitrates in your tank or pond exists. Also, the ammonia buildup is significant also, right? So I'm here, I'm gonna be moving some of the plants. This is my koi and my goldfish pond. I am gonna be removing some of the plants. I have already monitored. Oh, that's one of the beauty of, I don't know if you can see, but that bird right beside the pond is drinking water. That's one of the beauties why I love outdoors. Right? Birds, and except for the frogs, I don't like the frogs. Birds and other wild animals actually come across, drink a little water now and then, and you know, they move on. Now these plants are not really looking all that hot, so I might just remove them. You know what, I'm gonna let them stay. Let me see what happens. Anything, I'll actually remove them next week. Right, these plants are doing okay, but I'm gonna of course take them off and trim off the dead leaves and all that. So I've completed the whole idea of stripping my plants in my next IBC tote with dead leaves, right? This is the combination of both the koi and the swordtail. Sorry, this is the combination of both the koi and the goldfish stripping that have been made. This is my other tank, and from now on I will call it my sevum tank. Now I've discovered that the flies in this pond are sevum. The base of the pond might look as if it is made up of, it is covered with filth, but it's not. These are the green stuff beneath are algae that practically going at the base. Now if you look carefully, I'm going to see if I can stop the water a little bit, right? But if you look carefully at the bottom of the pond, you will realize that you have several brambles. Right, you, if you even look even very good, you might even see some of the flies in which I've been telling you about. Right, and there you have several actually holding one of the frogs in their mouth, and I am not worried anymore with regards to the frogs in this pond. And there's another one here, another frog. Right. Another frog here. They are just all over the place, but I just realized that yeah, several, or should I say the fish in this pond actually consume the frogs. You know they have flies, right? And frogs, I don't know if it's the flies they are going at, but they are actually doing some business with the frogs, tear them up in pieces, right? They call it small baby frogs, right? Okay, so I'm gonna be placing the plants in this pond. I've decided to allow this pond to stay a little bit. These are my drop them seeds. I might end up removing all these plants, but probably next week, because you know this weekend is holiday. So probably during the course of the week, like I'm not going to school, I'm not going to work, should I say, I will probably manage this pond that way. Alright, but this pond is doing okay. I've seen probably about a 7-8 inch drop dens in this. They are now becoming so, what call it now, so visible since I've removed the, so visible since I've actually removed the pleckers. Right, I think I'm going to be making, for the summer, I'm going to be making 200 gallon aquarium, in which I'll probably place some of the empty in, and hopefully my two Oscar around the front might be big enough to go with them.